kids? ¿Cómo se va? Does everybody feel good? Yeah. To be the workers. Yeah. To be the workers. Hey, I am your host. My name is Warren Black. Welcome to the Emerge Awards for 2018. Leave your troubles outside, my friends. Forget about them. Come inside, everything is beautiful. The art is beautiful. The finalists, they are beautiful. The food is beautiful. Everything is beautiful. We have more than 40 finalists out of almost 300 applicants from all kinds of places. That's why we say, I have a song for you now that is about class, sort of. So that was a song about glass. Most of the people here work with film-form glass, though. It's really hard to find songs about films. Have you ever tried to find a song about a film? There isn't a song out there. However, music has much to say about heat. Baby. You don't care for me, I don't. very much. Welcome to the Emerge 2018 Awards. A lot of the finalists are here. If you are your finalists, do some clapping out there for finalists out there. And I have been told we're going to do a group picture with all the finalists. So if you know a finalist or are a finalist, move your finalist to right over here by the long beautiful coat pieces. Over there by the lights after the awards. We're going to get afterwards. Very good. Alright, so who wants to hear from me? Okay. If I can have your attention, please. Lonnie McGregor of Bullseye Projects is going to step up here and tell us all. Lonnie's going to get up here and talk.
Who have really put their hearts and souls into this competition and exhibition. Can I get you all to raise your hands? Our people, hi Bullseye people. To bring this this event to its special Portland life. And next to the entire factory at Bullseye, the people who every day with their work give meaning to our life and to the lives of so many others involved in the art making at the heart of our world. Finally, thank you, the art makers here, with us this evening, in person and in spirit. Thank you in making, you give life to the best of what it is to be a citizen of this world community. This year we received almost 300 entries, 39 countries. Those countries may have different flags. Do we have some different flags? They may have different flags. They all have the Bullseye logo on them. Yes, they may have different flags, but the artists in them have one common heart. It is a heart that does not focus on borders. It is a heart that sees across lines to address the common values of what it means to be human, to work, to love, to cherish friends, to nurture family, and to embrace strangers. Those are the values that we believe are central to an arts education. To look for and embrace the differences, and to focus on the unique, the unusual, and the new perspectives. Whether you've learned to look in a formal arts program, do we have some formal arts programs up here? Or through private exploration, you have. There's arts education all over the world. Whether through a formal arts program or through online exploration, private exploration, whether in the classroom online or in an art making pilgrimage to a distant place. I want to make a toast this evening to the memory of a gentleman who embodies that path. Klaus Moyet grew up in the horrors of World War II Germany, became a folk singer, then an artist He immigrated to Australia and became a teacher. He came to the United States and inspired a Portland glass factory to make a whole new kind of glass. He also started a glass program, which is one of the many that is not listed here right now. I am thrilled that four decades later, that program in Canberra, Australia, is still one of the 37 schools from 13 countries who are represented at eMERGE 2018, even though they don't show up on the screen. Oh, they're all vacationing in the Alps. Okay, finally, I'm also delighted that this year's Evolve artists. Where are you? The two that are with us today, Cassandra and...
I'm hiding in the back.
Okay, Joanna, Cassandra, wherever you are, and Catherine, we know and we hope you are watching from New Zealand. Thank you also, as former students yourself and now teachers, whose strength as artists are all marked by travel and a deep connection to our international community. Thank you all for your art and for your teaching. And to you, Klaus, to all of us, to committed to art without borders, a toast. Thank you all. Now, Michael is going to take it over. Hopefully your slides will work better than mine.
They're going to work great.
Good.
Hello, everyone. In case you don't know me, my name is Michael Endo. I am the curator here at Bullseye Projects. I've never gotten applause there before, just saying my name. So one of the things that we have been doing, I actually figured it out today, this is my fifth eMERGE, which is just boggles my mind that I've participated in. My first task here at Bullseye was actually checking in everybody's work, and now I get to stand back and watch all these amazing people put together this amazing show, because although I'm the curator, I have very little to do with what you guys actually saw. And because I have to have my hands busy, I like to select three artists who are former eMERGE finalists or award winners, as Lonnie mentioned, to go into an exhibition that you saw when you first entered called Evolve. So the three artists represented in that show, Joanna Menousis, Cassandra Straubing, and Catherine Whiteman, have all gone through an evolution from their work from being eMERGE finalists or award winners. Yeah. Oh, no. Okay. Never mind. Okay, there we go. All right. So Joanna Menousis was actually one of the first pieces I ever unpacked as a registrar here at Bullseye for her piece in eMERGE 2010. That piece was a finalist. And then now, since then, those pieces, that particular piece that featured a core cast rolling pins, have now evolved into the pieces you saw downstairs, this amazing tour de, technical tour de force, including this pear and bronze piece. So the connection between her original work to this is just very strong between two. And then Cassandra Straubing also won the Kilncaster Award when we had that as a particular category. That particular piece of a kiln cast glass apron, now we can see the evolution of that into these exquisitely cast pieces that we saw downstairs, also from 2010. And then Catherine Whiteman, who won the Gold Award in 2014 for her piece Posey, as she was first developing the powder printing techniques that she's become world renowned for, and now explores very delicately and amazingly in the pieces that we can see downstairs. So I'm very excited to keep presenting the work, because one of the things about eMERGE is that eventually we move on to another stage in our career, and it's really exciting to see each of these artists, wherever they started, as they continue on into their on their path, and we're excited to see where they go even from here. So let's give a big round of applause to the artists. Craft and Design from the Pacific Northwest College of Art and the Oregon College of Art and Craft, joint MFA, something like that. Anyway, they looked at everyone's entries online, went through all of them, debated through multiple rounds to bring it down to the 49 finalists, and then met last weekend in order to go through and juror and select all of the award winners. Unfortunately, not everyone can win. It would have been good for me to review these slides before I got out. Yeah, it's a surprise. So then they are very intently looking at the pieces. This was actually an extremely exciting jury to participate in or witness. Because what you don't see in these photographs is that Lonnie, Mary Kay, and I are in the periphery over, like, listening in on everything they happen to say. And this particular jury was a very interesting conversation about presentation, about photography, about technical craft, about aesthetics. And so the conversation that sort of came out of the jury process, I wish we could have just recorded the whole thing and put that into the catalog. But unfortunately, not everyone can win an award, but the jurors do like to select around 3 honorable mentions. Usually each juror selects one individually that they thought was particularly noteworthy but did not quite win an award. This year, the 3 jurors collaborated and selected all 3 together. The first one is Andy Plummer's "I Moved on Her Like a Bitch." I don't like to say that on YouTube. The jurors were struck by both the political message as well as the beauty of the individual works, and if you have some time, definitely read his statement. The statement on the piece is extremely compelling, down to all of the minute details. Everything has been considered. It's even the slightly polished tips of these representations of 50 caliber bullets sort of reference the reverence that we put on religious objects. If you think about things that we touch over and over again and how that slowly polishes things over time. So all of these little details within the piece, even the spacing of the individual works, were all considered and all come through both aesthetically in the piece and then in the statement as well. Another one, Kalina Bonka's "Noise." So again, the jurors were struck by all of the considerations that Kalina put into her piece. Not only the scale, it is physically the largest piece in the exhibition, but also this balance of both representing the two-dimensional aspects of the graffiti and the stickers, but then also using glass to represent the three-dimensional aspects of these power, these sort of unremarkable pieces of the urban landscape. So all of those sort of coming through in this particular piece. And the third one is Evelyn Gottschall's "Butt Baker's Bones." One aspect of this jury that is different than all the other ones that I've participated in or witnessed is the difference between the award winners, the honorable mentions, and those who unfortunately didn't win awards was very slim. And it usually came down to just minute decisions the artists made having to do with presentation or just subtle considerations within the piece itself. And I can say that this particular piece, I think, there was a real struggle about whether or not it would cross the line into award-winning territory. And it really had to do with just some subtle differences between the artist that didn't win an award in presentation and this particular piece. So it's one of those things, aspects that when the catalog comes out and we have the jury interview, if you're looking to apply again in the future, thinking about those minute about that. Now I'm going to pass it on to Warren.
Okay, getting down to award time. I also wanted to mention, I said this before, finalists who are here, we're going to be doing a group picture afterwards. Who are you? You heard me talk about that, right? Okay, you're my favorite. Over here, just down toward the end, by the big June Kaneko panels, we're going to have all the finalists down there for a group picture once all the awards go out. And the awards start to go out now. Mary Kay, we bring the envelope from Price Waterhouse.
Confidential.
Nobody knows.
Need any help
with that? You tell how well rehearsed this is. My last day is Wednesday. Okay, we're going to start with the academic awards. I'm kind of curious to see what slide comes up. See if a slide comes up. Chris is back there pulling his hair out. Hello. Any of these buttons, Chris? Ah, here we go. Academic bronze. The Academic Bronze Award receives a $500 gift card from Bullseye Glass Company. And our winner. The winner, oh, okay, so the Academic Bronze Award goes to Jay Tapson from the University of Chicago. That's so great, come on up. Thanks for coming. Academic Silver. The Academic Silver Award is $1,250 gift card from Bullseye Glass Company. It goes to Rosemary Faulkner from the ANU School of Art. We will see what Rosemary gets. Academic Gold. The Academic Gold Award is $2,500 gift card from Bullseye Glass. And the award, the Gold Award, goes to Joshua Curley from the World College of Art in the UK. Has recently begun working in glass, changing mediums in the last couple years. A little louder, Reese. Let's bridge over troubled water. I just wanted to make sure we got things. Bridge, crossing over. Okay. The Crossover Award is a $5,000 gift card from the Bullseye Glass Company, and it goes to Allison Lee Holt. It goes to Dagmar Abjeleka. Poland's a long way to come from, so she didn't get it. Very good. The Silver Award Can you feel the excitement building? You like the suit? The new suit. Okay. Let me get that in. The shoes, thank you. Yeah. Very proud of the shoes. All right, the Silver Award, which is a $2,500 gift card from Bullseye Glass Company, goes to Claire Peters. Thank you, Claire. Congratulations. And now, the big one, the Gold Award. A $5,000 gift card from Bullseye Glass Company. And the winner of the Gold Award in the Emerge 2018 competition goes to good rehearsal. Saman Kalantar. Congratulations to Saman. For all of and throughout the end, I have just one thing that I wanted to say. You'll be swell. You'll be great. Gonna have the whole world on a plate. Start from here, start from now. Honey, everything's coming, the roses. Take a bow, you've got nothing to do but relax. Start from here, start from now. Honey, everything's coming, the roses. So thanks everybody for coming once again. The finalists should be down there. Big thank you, big round of applause for all the finalists. Thank you, Michael, and all the folks at Bullseye. I just want to say, everything's coming up. Sunshine and clouds, foyer. Some of his stuff is down there. Everything's coming up. Clear Fritz and lots of cool working. One more. Everything's coming up. Specific gravity. 2.5, that's specific gravity.